This is my channel AJ Studio. So today we are going to discuss a few things about OpenGL, that is how to run a OpenGL program. In the previous video we have installed GLUT library in Visual Studio, that is GLUT, graphics library utility toolkit. Today we are going to run this OpenGL program, how to run a OpenGL program. So let us open a Visual Studio. Here there is a sample code of OpenGL. You can see over here. Let me run this code. Okay, so you can see here, start debugging. Click on this. It will ask for, would you like to build it? Yes. Just click on yes and it will build the code for you. And afterwards, after some time, you can see over here, this is the output. You can see the line is drawn. It is a blue color line and the background is white. And you can see over here, lines is displayed here. You can see what is displayed, lines. So this is a sample program, OpenGL program to run. Okay, let me explain the code, how it will work. Okay, so let's see the first line. Let's always the program starts from int main, so void main or int main. So int main, so here this is the command prompt arguments, so command line arguments. So this is the argc, means number of arguments. This is what are the arguments you are passing, that is argument v. Normally it will be useful for your OpenGL projects and all, it will be useful, not here. Okay, so but still it is a syntax should be used for OpenGL programs. That is the first line. So in int main, the first line of the program, glut init. Okay, glut init. So glut means g means graphics, G is graphics, L means library, U means utility, T means toolkit. Init means initialization. See, let's consider you want to start a bike. So you should initialize the bike. That means you should have bike, tires, and everything should be initialized. If you want to start a car, you should initialize the car, whether it is working. So that's the in OpenGL program, in graphics library function or OpenGL, you should initialize it. What you should initialize is that are the number of how many number of arguments. So you can see number of arguments and what is the type of argument you are passing. So the same thing, command line argument. So always OpenGL program starts with the glut init, that is glut, graphics library utility toolkit, initialization. So initialize, so starting. Okay, afterwards after initialization, you should tell what type of display mode you are using. So that is why glut init display mode, what type of display mode you are using. Either you are using a single or RGB. So it can be used single, or you can see here, this is a pipelining or symbol. Okay, RGB. So single means single color model. Okay, RGB means red, green, blue. Okay, red, green, blue. So you know what is the full form of glut. Glut means graphics library utility toolkit. So it can be single or RGB. Okay, RGB means red, green and blue. So afterwards, after setting the display mode, next line is init window size. Okay, you are setting the size of the window. So how to set the window size? So I am giving length and breadth as 500 400. So window size will be 500 400. This is the most important thing to set the size. When I when you run the program, you can see, you have seen a window. Okay, you have seen a window, that size is 500 400. If you change it, the size of the, it varies. You can try it. Okay, you can try it by changing the values. So next, glut init window position 00. Normally this is the window position where it should start. Normally window position will start from here. Okay, that is top left. Okay, normally top left 00. So let me show it. Okay, start debugging. Okay, when I start debugging, you can see always the this window always starts from top left because it is attached to top left. Okay, don't think that 00 means it is a bottom left, it is a top left. Okay, that is why it is 00. If you want, you can change this 00. Okay, I will give x as 100. Okay, I'll give x as 100. So always this one is x axis, this one is y axis, 100 and 0. I'll give window position as 100 and 0. You see the change. I'll debug it. I'll click on s. You can see here, when I run this program, you can see there is a gap. Okay, here gap, x axis gap is there. That means 100 gap is there, okay, that in terms of x-axis, okay, that is why I will make it as 0, 0 only. I don't want to change that, let it be 0, 0, okay. And afterwards, glut create window. So afterwards, you are creating a window and you should name that as lines. When you run the program, you can see it as it will display it as lines, okay. When you run this, okay, you can see. You can see over here it is lines, okay, it is the lines, so it's very clear. Window name is line, create window, you have given it as line. So this is ortho 2D, this is your axis, okay. So normally this is a 2D one, okay, where you are going to set the 2D axis. Ortho is one of the viewing axis which we'll study in further programs when we do that. Ortho means orthographic view, 2 means two dimension, okay. Here there are 4 parameters are there, you can see first parameter, second parameter and third and fourth. Four, what are these parameters? First one is left, right, bottom, top, okay, that is left, right, bottom, top. So when you draw a screen, okay, left will be 0, okay, left will be 0, right is 499, that means from left to right, what is the gap? So bottom is 0, 0, okay, bottom is 0, 0 and up is 499. So if I run this, okay, when I run this program, okay, their left is this left is 00, okay, and this one is 499. This window, inside window, there is, will be inside window, that is ortho, and bottom will be 00 and top will be 499. So you have set the scale. So when you set the scale, that when you are drawing a line, that line should be inside this scale only, because I have the set the scale as this one as 0 and this one as 499, and when this one is 0 and this one as 499 in the program. So this is the scale I am displaying, okay. And these all lines, okay, these are normal function, okay, normal functions, okay, functions are there, okay. But these two, okay, last two lines are not normal function, these are called as callback functions, okay. Why this is callback? Because glut display function, okay, it will call function call, it will call display which is over here, which is over here, okay. This is a callback display function, okay. Glut display function is inbuilt, where you will give inside this display, this display and this display name should be same, okay. And finally there will be last line, glut main loop, and this will make sure that this loop, that is main loop, will be will run infinitely without any problem, infinitely, okay. Main loop, it will be inside this, it will make sure that this loop will be executing continuously. You see, when I run this program, this window will be executing continuously because of that main loop. When I close this window, main loop will stop. Until then it will be one, it's like while loop one, okay, in C, okay. When while is one, it will execute continuously. When I break, so when you close it, it will break, okay. Now we will go for display function. Okay, void display is this one is function definition, this is function call, this is function call, it is a callback function. In OpenGL we'll call it as callback function. So here display, the first line you can see here, GL clear color. See, I am when I run the program, you can see the background as white. So I am making the background as white by GL clear color. GL means graphics library, clear means I'm clearing what I'm clearing color. So here there are 4 parameters are there. First parameter is RGBA, okay, RGBA. R means red, G means green, B means blue, A means that is alpha value. Alpha value will be opaque or transparent, okay. 1 means opaque, 0 means transparent, okay. That is the 4 values. So clear, I'm clearing it, okay. Clear 1 1 1 means if everything is 1 means it is white, it is white, and if everything is 0 means it is black, okay. If everything is 0 means it is black. Normally if you want a screen, means I'm clearing the screen, okay. So I'm making the background screen as white. Afterwards, see if any already something is drawn, okay. So if it is in the buffer, it should clear it, okay. In OpenGL, normally when you draw it, everything will be stored in buffer, okay. Everything will be stored in a buffer. So that is why you should clear the buffer, GL clear. Inside that GL, that is graphics library, what you have to clear? Color you have to clear. Where? From buffer, okay. Normally these whatever drawing is there, that will be stored in frame buffer. So you are clearing the buffer bit by bit, okay. You are clearing the buffer bit by bit because it will be stored in bits, okay. It will be stored in bits. So you are clearing the buffer. That is why you are using clear. If you are not clearing, means already some values will be there, so that will be the problem, okay. Now you are setting the color, okay. Now next line will be setting the color. You can see your GL color. You are setting the color 3f. 3 means 3 colors, okay. That is 3 parameters. F means floating, okay. F means floating value. 3 means 3 values, okay. Well, you can see here 1, 2 and 3. So what normally you are using, what type of color? RGB. See here, I am making R as 0, G as 0, B as 1. There are 3 values are there. I repeat here, there are 3 values. First will be R, second will be G, third one will be B. Okay, when I make B as 1, you will see blue color. See, I will debug the program. When I debug the program, you can see the color of the line is blue. If I want to make red color, I can make this one as 0 and this one as 1. Okay, now you can see R I have made as first parameter, I have made as 1, and I'll run this. Now I'll debug and I'll click yes, okay, and now I'll run the program. You can see the color of the line is red. Why? Because I made some changes in the program, that is what? R as 1, okay. Now after setting the color, now you are beginning the drawing. See, after setting the color, you are clearing the buffer, then you are setting the color, then afterwards you are beginning something. What you are beginning? Yeah, when you want to draw something, you always when you draw something, you should begin, okay. That is why you are using begin. What you are beginning? You are beginning lines. You are drawing what? Line. GL underscore lines. You are beginning some lines, GL underscore lines. So these are called as different parameters are there, okay. Primitives are there. These are not parameters, primitives, okay. I am using lines as on primitives. You can use any different parameter. Primitives are there. You can give points, a triangle, so according to that it will change. What I am drawing is lines, okay. I am drawing is lines. So for drawing lines, so see, you know, when you want to draw a line, okay, when I debug this, okay, you can see very clearly. See, if I want to draw a line, how many points should be required? 2 points I required. 2 points for drawing a line. How many points? 2 points for drawing a triangle. 3 points. So that is a major important thing you must know. So I am drawing lines, that means I need to draw 2 points. That is why GL vertex 2i 2 times I have called. So that means 2 points. The first point, GL graphics library vertex. Vertex is nothing but point, okay. Vertex is nothing but point. First point, vertex. So you will call it as vertex. 2 means 2 parameters. 2 means 2 parameters. What are those 2? I means integer, okay. I means integer. F means float over here. I means integer. What are 2 parameters? X and Y. X is the 20, Y means 20. Okay, X 20, Y 20. Okay, same way you are, this is first point. This is a first point and this one is second point. Same way, okay, same way, second point. So when you are finished with the drawing, you are finished, okay. Now see, you have started begin. If you begin, you must end it, okay. You must end it. Very important thing, if you begin, you should end it. That is why begin always have end. And finally you will have flush. What is this flush? I told, when in OpenGL, when you draw something, okay, when you draw something, I'll just type over here. When you draw something, it will be stored, okay. These all will be stored in, okay, stored in frame buffer, okay. It will be stored in buffer. So I want everything. Okay, these all things should be displayed. Okay, this should be displayed. You have drawn everything. You have begin and end. All things will be stored in a frame buffer. That is buffer. Okay, from buffer it should be flushed to the display. That is why you are using a flush. GL flush means a very important concept here. A flush means you are flushing from buffer. That is frame buffer to where display. I want to display it. Okay, you are flushing from frame buffer to display. If you don't use flush, the output will be not seen. Why? Because it will be in buffer itself. It will be in buffer itself. Okay, I will change the values over here. If I give 2020, it's here you can see 2020. Okay, I'll give 100, 100, 100 here. First point is 100, 100. And the second point is 180, 180. Okay, I'll make this change and I will run this. You can see the these two points will change. Okay, I'll run this. Yes, you can see there is a gap. This first point is 100, 100, and second point is 180, 180. So this is a simple program to display a line in Visual Studio. Okay, I hope you understood, and thank you for watching the video, and don't forget to subscribe, share and like.